me to sound the trumpet of his word. And the book, Jesus is Africa, is one of the ways that I'm doing that.
The book, Jesus is Africa, is a deliberate illumination of the link between the African continent and Christianity and a tie that stretches the length of biblical history. In the book, Pastor Patience extensively discusses the role of the church and in particular the African church in God's plan to redeem nations and her spiritual encounter with God at the age of 11, which set her on the path to preach the gospel. In his speech during the launch of Jesus is Africa, President Yoweri Museveni advised Africans to consolidate Africa's victory through economic and political integration. The president thanked his daughter, Pastor Patience Rwabwogo, not only for the depth of the knowledge in the book, but also linking it with African patriotism and Pan-Africanism to show that if you don't defend your birthright, the thief can take it away and God can bless him. The president also urged Ugandans that Africa has everything and they should not be intimidated by those threatening to cut off aid.
These children became the Edomites in the Bible. So, to remove that curse of selling the birthright, that's the problem. Otherwise, Africa, we have everything. When some people say we shall cut off aid, what aid are you giving? We don't need aid. We have everything here.
He described Pastor Patience as the only priest in the family since the arrival of Christianity in 1877 for Anglicans and Catholics in 1879.
To have a priest in my family for the first time in 140 years. This is because for us we are cattle keepers. We are cattle keepers. We have nothing to do with all other things. Just cows, and some crops. But now Patience has shown us that you can be a cattle keeper, but also a priest.
In her speech, Pastor Patience Rwabwogo told the gathering how she received a revelation from God in 2005 when she saw the vision of God's redemptive purpose for Africa.
I heard God's voice say, "Out of what was called darkness will come a great light." And that this light would come from within us. I discovered that the vision that Uganda is the heart of Africa, and that as Uganda aligns with God's redemptive purpose, it will have a domino effect in the rest of Africa. That was the beginning of the revelation, and over the last 17 years, the revelation has continued to grow.
Pastor Patience Rwabwogo also paid gratitude to her parents, whom she said have been her encouragement and support all her life. The 461-page book, Jesus is Africa, was edited by Dr. Matunda Nyachama from Semia Publishing in Kenya. He described President Museveni as a leader and a thinker for Africa.
We pray for you. We hope that you will continue having good health because there's a lot that is left for you to accomplish. And one of which is really bringing this continent together, economically, politically, religiously, so that we are one people.
In attendance was Pastor Dr. Dorcas Rigathi, the Second Lady of the Republic of Kenya. Pastor Dorcas described Pastor Patience as a woman of profound vision and exemplary talent.
Book Jesus is Africa, that we have gathered here to launch. This woman is a woman of great vision who has put together a work of divine wisdom with razor sharp and unwavering passion. Our daughter, we are proud of you.
The First Lady, Janet Kataha Museveni, thanked Pastor Dr. Dorcas Rigathi, Dr. Jim Holly, and other guests for honoring her daughter Patience's invitation to travel and be present at the launch.
We pray that you will heal and release our land from the curse and judgment that has been witnessing against us all these many years. We pray that the blood that was shed on the land that will no longer bear witness against us, and that instead it will now produce in abundance for the blessing and prosperity of our nations on this continent.
The colorful function was attended by ministers, members of parliament, religious leaders, among others.